We are now about 24 hours away from the next launch window for the Artemis 1 mission.
NASA leaders met today and gave the go-ahead for tanking the SLS rocket to launch early Wednesday morning. And this launch has had a lot of setbacks due to technical issues and two hurricanes that hit the space coast. But that is not stopping the launch for now. Officials say some of the caulk on the Orion's launch abort system came loose during the storm. Technicians have also been working to replace an electrical connector, but NASA says the connector will not impede the launch.
We know we have redundancy in these other measurements, and we are still okay to launch. The unanimous recommendation for the team was we were in a good position to go ahead and proceed into launch countdown with these measurements.
One of the popular locations to watch the launches will not be available this time around. Here's a look at the sign outside of Jetty Park and campground saying it's closed. Crews are still cleaning up debris left over from Hurricane Nicole, and the park will not be cleared up in time for the launch.
Titusville police are also asking drivers to slow down in launch viewing areas, especially on US 1 and State Road 406 along the AMAX Brewer Bridge. All lanes on the bridge will be closed immediately after the launch for about an hour so pedestrians can safely cross. Officials could potentially close the bridge to drivers before the launch as well. And we will have special coverage on West 2 before and during the launch starting at 12:30 on Wednesday morning. The launch window will open at 1:04 a.m.